Hey folks, Rob with Two Guys in a Ride. Boy oh boy, do I have a treat for you. Today we are at the Tampa Bay Automobile Museum and I am here with the owner and curator and guy with the biggest sickness in the world because he collects these beautiful vehicles. Olivier, tell us a little bit about yourself. Tell us about the museum. Tell us how we can find the museum online and in person.
Sure. So first of all, this collection got started with my father. With his first car, 1957, which this is his first car. He's had it since 57 and in France. And then right next to it, the Delahaye that he got to, probably 1961, around there. He didn't have too much money and needed transportation, so he decided those were cheap back then, you know, $100 a piece, and then he kept them. He kept all his cars for 4 or 5 years. Well, he kept his car, and in 1980, we brought the car over to the U.S., the five cars he had, and then after that, the collection started, engineering. So we got a sleeve valve car, a Panhard Dynamique, because we didn't know what a sleeve engine was and we wanted to learn more about it. So we brought it in, we figured it out, and then next to the next one. And that's how the collection grew crazy with my father, the culprit, and I. To build a very special museum.
So, you know, you talk about the focus of your museum is engineering and the technology of the day. And again, I'm going to say it multiple times in this video, but again, someone had to do these things first, and that's your passion is engineering. So
right.
You've focused on that, and your collection is part of that. So what do we have in here now?
Well, we have the very first car, 1770, right? So. It was a steam car, so it was. This is you're looking at a boiler.
Right.
You heat up the wood. You stick the wood inside here.
Oh, wow!
And then you've got a tubular boiler. So it was the very first high pressure boiler. It was only 30 psi.
Right.
But still.
Right.
1770, and it was made to carry cannons because the horses, the cannons were getting bigger. The horses didn't have the strength. So the French army hired Cugnot, an engineer, and to build this vehicle. And you will notice that it's an engineering here is crazy simple. Right. You have the very first linear to rotary motion, and those are the big pistons that the steam
right.
go through, and it has reverse. It has forward, and this is actually a front-wheel drive car.
Right, right,
right?
Yes, yes.
So, rack and pinion steering, it's amazing. So this is an exact replica.
Right.
The original is in Paris. It's missing the boiler. It's missing a few parts to it.
Okay.
And so we've decided to make it because you read in books, did it run, did it not run? Nobody really knew. If the vehicle ran before, so in 2004, we decided, we went on into a 6 years project into remaking it. The,
right.
the frames was done, I quote, like it was before, it was done in France.
Wow.
The boiler is a tubular boiler, that was done in Connecticut. A lot of different components came from different parts of the world, but we wanted to be exact. And yeah, it does run.
Oh my
it
gosh.
actually, it will not go. It will be only shown where it can run. We'll never be static because it's so impressive with the steam.
Right.
That we run it. Once or twice a year, it goes out and runs.
So when you build up the, because like steam locomotives, you have to have a coal car. You have to have the stop
yes.
every so many miles and get water. So in doing this with this, just your boiler and everything
right.
here, how far could this go?
So
without shoving more.
So
wood?
here's you got the water here.
I like okay? the bourbon.
And the bourbon is because of the Louis XVI family name was bourbon.
Oh, is that right?
Right.
Okay.
Sometimes I wish it was real bourbon
oh.
in there, but it's just water.
Okay.
And then so you have a hand pump. In here
okay.
that you can pump water into the boiler.
So there's your water reservoir.
So,
okay.
your water reservoir. This is your basket for the wood.
Oh, okay.
So,
and here's a picture of you guys actually running it.
Yes, so. That was the very first time it ran, and that was in Paris.
Oh, with Barry McGuire.
Yep.
All right.
Yeah, he saw it, he wanted a ride.
Oh, sure. Barry's excited. He likes all types of cars. That's cool. I'm glad he was able to ride it. Okay. Wow.
So yeah, and just it's very, very simple.
Look at this. But again, the technology and the engineering for someone engineering, to sit and, yeah. and produce this.
Just imagine 1770, you know, the people in the streets, I mean, when they saw this, the testing going on, they must have run away, right?
Oh, right,
right.
They didn't know what it was. It was something from outer space.
It's like a big monster.
Wow. Oh my gosh. Look at that. Lots of neat stuff here.
So,
wow.
Yeah,
wow.
Then we can go on and on, but this is right here, the very, then Benz, the motor wagon that the first gasoline engine, not the very first gasoline engine, but a gasoline engine with a car moving that. And that's 100 years later or more. Right?
Oh, right.
So that's 1885, 1885, wow. 1770.
Exactly.
So 115 years later, you know, that's...
Wow.
But this the reason this was a very secretive is because it was from the Army. So once the tests were done,
yep.
And when the, you know, the change of the governments and so forth back then,
right.
They put it away and nobody could see it. And
right.
So that was that. And it was stored, the original was stored in the late 18th, early 1800, they went to the museum already, so it was stored there,
okay.
and then it was, you know, that's how it never got destroyed too.
Right.
The original
military
one.
Secret. So
yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Wow.